Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, I will make the palm trees for your miniatures and terrain scenery. These palm trees can be made for basically any scale, and I will use them in one of my upcoming projects. So here we have the base materials. Here I have some florist wire in two sizes, one being slightly thicker than the other. Some milipat or green stuff. And here we have some liquid green stuff or plastic putty. A pencil. Here I have some black peppercorns. And finally some leftover plastic blister parts. So here we go. I start off by taking two pieces of the thicker florist wire and cutting them in half. You could use other types of metallic wire, but I find this florist wire is really flexible and easy to work with. I then fix the wire in place using some masking tape. Make sure you line them up in a cylinder shape. I now started twisting the thinner florist wire around the frame. Try to keep the wire close together and tight. When you've reached the masking tape, it can be cut away at this point. Just keep adding more wire until you've reached the length that you want. At this point, I clipped off any excess bits. I decided making 5 of them to use in my upcoming project. At this stage, I bend the tops slightly outwards in this shape. For the bottom part, I bend 3 wires outwards, leaving one facing downwards. I will now clip the wires a bit shorter. I recommend wearing safety goggles when doing this. When this was done, I then placed them in some pieces of cork to hold them steady. At this stage, you can decide if you want to bend them slightly or a lot. To fill in the bottom and tops, I mixed up some milipat. You could also use green stuff, of course. But I find this milipat is a bit softer and a bit easier to work with. I used a few modeling tools to shape the bottom of the trees. Using the thicker florist wire, I poked in a few holes in the putty. I then used this plastic putty to cover the tree trunks. You could also use liquid green stuff. Afterwards, I used some water to make it smooth. We don't want to lose the texture of the wire on the tree trunk. When the putty was dry, I then carefully sanded it using this nail sanding stick. Should you ever need one of these, you could plunder your girlfriend's makeup bag. I then started cutting out a few plastic blister pieces I had left over from my miniatures. I decided making 14 leaves per tree. When this was done, I cut the individual leaves in the shape I wanted. This is pretty time consuming, however, and you could also use a serrated scissor to make it a bit easier. To make sure the paint will stick to the plastic, I placed the leaves in this kitchen degreaser and then soak them for half an hour. When this was done, I used a toothbrush to clean them a bit better and then rinsed them in some clean water. I will now try and make some dead leaves. I took a pencil and broke off its point. I then used this pencil sharpener to get some of these pencil shavings. I made sure to remove the colored outside bits of the pencil. In order to color the pencil shavings, I used some water and added two tones of brown ink to it. You could also use a brown wash for this step. I then soaked the pencil shavings in the ink for half an hour. When this was done, I dried them off using some paper towels. Afterwards, I transferred them to a sheet of baking paper so they can dry without sticking to the paper towel. What I have here are some dried peppercorns, which I will use as coconuts for the trees. Make sure you select the smooth ones and not the wrinkled ones. I messed this up at first and had to replace them later. I applied some PVA glue to the tops of the trees. In order to attach the peppercorns easily, I also dipped them in some super glue. This combination of glue makes it set almost instantly. At this stage, I applied some PVA to the bottoms of the trees. I then covered it using some baking soda. This will make a very fine texture on it. I then clipped off some pieces of this copper wire I have here and applied it to the leaves using the PVA superglue combination. When all the leaves were done, I applied two thin layers of Tamiya Gray primer to it. I recommend using a lacquer-based primer for this step, as this will stick to the plastic much better. I also applied Tamiya gray primer to the tree trunks. When the primer had dried, I airbrushed the leaves using Goblin Green. I made some shadows on them using Sick Green. I applied some red terracotta to the leaves to give them some more color. Afterwards, I highlighted the leaves using gold yellow. The tree trunks were base coated using khaki brown. I made some shadows here and there using camo medium brown. To seal in the paint and protect the models, I applied a coat of gloss varnish to them. I painted the coconuts using a mix of olive green and Japan uniform. The tree trunks were then shaded using Army Painter's soft tone ink. At this point, I had replaced the wrinkled peppercorns with the smooth ones, because I thought the other ones kinda looked like Kermit the Frog's testicles. Here I slightly bent the copper wire and the plastic leaves as well. I clipped the copper wire slightly and then attached them to the tree trunks using PVA and superglue. So here we have our fake dead leaves. I decided to crumble them up slightly. I applied a layer of PVA to the upper part of the tree and then added the dead leaves to them. To make sure the leaves and coconuts will stay in place, I applied this glue mixture to it using a pipette. When the glue had dried, I applied the final coat of matte varnish to the models. This will remove the glossiness of the glue as well. So here we have the finished palm trees. I didn't place them on their bases yet, because I will use these in one of my upcoming projects. So that'll wrap up this video. I really hope you've enjoyed it and that it was of any help to you. I will leave you now with some pictures of the finished models. As always, thank you for watching, stay tuned for more, and take care.
Work complete.